even just on this very channel, you've probably seen this XKCD countless times. The dependency one. All modern digital infrastructure, it's all complicated. There's a bunch of things on top of a bunch of things, and everything is held up by this random project by someone in Nebraska who's been thanklessly maintaining this since 2003. This applies to tools like curl, like FFmpeg, libraries like libinput. And the web has experienced the danger of this with libraries like Leftpad. But this is just the surface. There are countless other tools that all fit in that exact same category. But let me show you a project that I've discussed before on this channel, which about a month ago was not that tool. Was not that tool at all. No one cared about it. And then all of a sudden, it's become a very, very important piece of digital infrastructure. Or at the very least, quickly turning into that important pillar. So this is Anubis. I've talked about it on the channel before. It's basically a way to stop these AI scrapers running up your server bills really, really high. It uses a proof of work based system that forces site visitors basically to do a bit of very expensive, complex maths with their computer. Now, for your singular system, this is annoying. It's maybe going to be like, depending on the difficulty, depending on the device, 3-5 second delay. Sometimes it can be longer, but it should be somewhere in that range. And that's fine as an individual. Yeah, it's slightly annoying, but it's fine. But if we're talking about an AI scraper, and you're making millions upon millions of requests, that adds up very, very quickly.
Shh, you didn't see the whiteboard change. I'm not going to redo the start of the video.
Now, immediately you might be thinking, this doesn't sound like a great solution. Yes, for the individual, it's not that big of a deal. But it's not just the individual that is going to be making a lot of requests. It's also lots of regular users. So this is lots of wasted CPU cycles, lots of wasted electricity, and for new users, might turn them away from the website since the site is loading really slowly. Also, it does get in the way of search engine indexing because, you know, they also have to do a bit of scraping as well. It's usually far less aggressive, but in many cases, they're still going to get caught up in this as well. All of this is understood by the developer, and it is self-described as a bit of a nuclear option. Nuclear options are going to have side effects. But with how bad the problem is becoming, some of those side effects are worth it. And we know they're worth it because we know about some of the places this has now been deployed. In a blog post by the developer, simply titled, Anubis Works. All of this started with Amazon taking down their Git server, and it led to their software being deployed by the United Nations. This is not a joke. This is not hyperbole. This is something that has actually happened. Now, let's just go back to the start briefly. So, all of this started with Amazon taking down their Git server. This was done back in January. First published back in January. I wrote a little proxy that does proof of work check before allowing requests to my Gitty server. It's called Anubis, and we're writing a blog post about it soon. For now, check it out right here at their server. It's a little rough around the edges, but it works enough. Which, you know what? Even if it's not perfect, enough is better than nothing. And from there, basically they kept improving upon it, and now we get closer to where we are now. Anubis has since become its own full-fledged project with a documentation site. If this helps you, please donate to my not having a day job fund over on Patreon. So, with that, it takes us to now. So, you've all probably heard about the GNOME GitLab making use of this tooling. That's just one big thing. Here we have a list of notable things that are making use of it. I don't know why, but the dev did not include links here, which great, because this makes it seem like it's on the homepage. It's not. Luckily, though, there are links somewhere else. Here is the Anubis documentation. I don't know if this page was here the last time I looked at Anubis. Maybe it was. Either way, though, obviously we have the GNOME GitLab. Is it going to show it? Or, yep, okay. It's going to do it right there. We have bugs.winehq.org. I must have recently visited that one, otherwise it would have worked. We have the FreeBSD SVN, which also already went through it. We have the FFmpeg website, which is going to do it. They're running a slightly older version of it before the mascot changeover. We have Source Hut, which also went through straight away. We're not doing a good job of showing it off. Purism. Purism. Is there a good way to make sure this is being triggered? What if I try it over in a clean version of Brave? Trust me, it is here. It's just not showing up because I visited recently and, yeah. Also, it's on the Enlightenment GitLab, or Git instance, not GitLab, which is... There it is! Also running a slightly older version. Is it gonna load? Maybe the rest of the site's dead, but the page is here! Maybe my system, for whatever reason, is just being treated as a real user. There's nothing weird, sketchy about it. I don't know how to make it trigger. I'm sure there's some more consistent way to do it that's not documented. Yeah. If the dev happens to know a very good way to trigger it, I would like to know. That would be good. If you see this, let me know in the comment section. Also, it should be on the LKML archive, not the one on lkml.org or whatever, on lore.kernel.org. Again, not gonna show it. I have seen it appear before, so it is definitely here. If you go to it, you'll sometimes see it. Aha! Saw that? See, the problem we have here is I am just very human, and the AI detection, it knows this. It sees, look at this very human design. Must be a person. Maybe they will trigger over in Chrome, just because I don't actually use it that often. Yeah, here we go. Okay, for some reason, I don't know why Brave wasn't triggering it. Let's try Source Hut. Is that going to do it as well? Yeah, there we go. And they have their own custom branding here. See, I wasn't lying. I'm just a person. Now, those are the notable FOSS ones. A lot of the others here are just random people's GitLabs. Things like this one here. I think it's a Giddy, maybe? I don't recall. We'll see. Giddy or GitLab? What do we have? Show me. What are you? Giddy? Yeah, that's a Giddy. Now, yes, we do have bug trackers like FFmpegs, like Wines, but a lot of the other ones here, like Source Hut, like various GitLabs and Gitties, or the SVN for FreeBSD. The reason why all of these are here is... AI scrapers tend to have zero respect for the resources they are pulling from. And with a website, there's only so many things you can do, right? Like, you can go to the website, you can query it a lot of times. Like, that's annoying, but, like, that's, like, normal user behavior. Maybe it's extra traffic than you'd normally see, but it's still pretty normal behavior. But... with Git repos, you're having them spam out things like git blame, like the entire git log. I assume there are similar commands with SVN as well, and these can get very, very expensive. When one user is doing it, that's fine. When you're doing it every 30 minutes, every hour, and there's hundreds of thousands of requests doing so, you're going to have an expensive bill very quickly, because again... a lot of these tools have zero respect for the resources they're pulling from. This is not like a search engine crawler. Yes, they do increase the cost of running a server, but at this point they are quite optimized and are treated as kind of a marginal cost. Yes, it's something that's slightly annoying, but it's not a big deal, especially for the benefit you get from having, you know, yourself listed in a search engine. The AI scrapers end up being the majority of the cost for a lot of these services. With that being said, it doesn't mean some random other sites aren't using them. Here is one. This is the Science Olympiad Student Center. I don't know what they've been dealing with AI scrapers that they felt the need to deploy this, but, they have. Now, before we get to the United Nations, which we will get to, don't worry about that, I briefly want to talk about the mascot. Not this mascot, but the original one. This has been accused of being AI generated, which you might think is hypocrisy for what the project is doing. And yes, it is AI generated. This is not a secret. The dev is entirely honest about this. Not the new logo. The new logo is made by an actual artist. But the original one on screen right now, that is AI generated. This is what the dev has to say. I'm going to be totally honest. The current Anubis design, that being the old one before the new one was made, is a placeholder because I didn't expect this to take off. Remember, this was a little project they made to deal with their Git server. That is all. And then it got deployed on the GNOME GitLab and a bunch of other places. And now it has like 3,500 stars on GitHub and it's suddenly really popular. I'm privately commissioning an EU-based artist to make human-authored art. I'm sorry if this feels like a bait and switch. I really just need the placeholder to give the project visual identity, and other such projects of mine have died on the vine. But really, I am commissioning a human artist for the future redesign. Basically, they wanted some sort of logo, and the goal the entire time was to get actual art done. I know a lot of people just full stop don't like AI art, but if you're just using it as a placeholder and the goal long-term is to replace it, frankly, I don't think that is any worse than just grabbing an image off of Google Images. Like, that's basically the same thing. Now, let's talk about the United Nations. If you go to their main website, you're not gonna see anything because it's not deployed here. Okay? I didn't lie to you, though. So, where it is deployed is on a subdomain of the UNESCO website. Of course, it's not going to load on this one. Let's go do it over in Chromium. Okay. See? Random subdomain of the UNESCO website uses Anubis. Why? I have no idea. I'm assuming somebody that works there is some FOSS fan. Maybe they watch this channel. If you happen to be that person, you happen to know the person who did this, explain yourself. If I had to guess why it was being used on this subdomain, this is a search tool for finding a bunch of different policies. So for these AI question answering tools, things like that, this is very valuable information that they would want to get their hands on. I hate to shake my can and ask for donations, but if you're using Anubis and it helps, please donate on Patreon. I would really love to not work in generative AI anymore because the doublethink is starting to wear at my soul. So this is something fun. They actually have done talks on affording AI chatbots and things like that. So at one time, working on a tool to slow down these AI tools, at another time, discussing how to make use of these AI tools in various different ways. Like, these two things understandably would split a lot of people apart and feel kind of weird. You know, they want to deal with the problem on their personal system, but still work in this space. You know, it's... I'm not going to tell anyone not to do what they want to do, but I get why that might bother some people. The conversation I'm about to have with my accountant is going to be one of the most surreal conversations of all time. I love when anybody is able to start work on a project that they created themselves, not going and working at some company and getting paid to work on it, but actually being able to take a project and it becomes so important that that's viable to do. Now, maybe it's not there just yet, but it's certainly on the way there. The part that's the most wild to me is when I stop and consider the scale of these organizations. I think this means that the problem is much worse than I had previously anticipated. I know that at some point YouTube was about to hit the inversion where they get more bot traffic than they get human traffic. I wonder how much of this is true across most of, if not all, of the internet right now. I guess this means that I really need to start putting serious amounts of effort into Anubis and the stack around it. The best way that can be ensured is if I can get enough money to survive so I can put my full-time effort into it, I may end up hiring people. I wish the dev the absolute best of luck, and I will be doing a podcast with them when we sort out the time and date. Soon. I don't know what it'll be uploaded, but it will happen. Also, since it's kind of funny, I don't really know why he's doing this, but Vaxby, the developer of Hyperland, has decided that he wants to, like, start this weird fight with the developer of Anubis. Don't really know why. They haven't responded at all. And he went and made this, which is Checkpoint, which is basically the same kind of idea as Anubis. That's cool. I like more open source tech existing. Don't really know why, but that's cool. I wasn't planning to make a video on it, so I guess we're just, yeah, there you go. Mentioned here. That's all I'm going to mention it because I don't actually care. Because Anubis is deployed on a random United Nations subdomain. For some reason. Anyway, if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Zilly Barapay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and now I do this.